I will not be another flower, picked for my beauty and left to die. I'll be wild, difficult to find, and impossible to forget. It's a proverb by Erin Van Wooren. Hello viewers, this is Shubha and welcome back to my channel Green Thumb. I'm super excited to present to you today my all-time favorite plant called Orchid Cactus or Queen of the Night. I love it as this is the only night blooming plant I have at home. How exciting it is to see a flower bloom at night. I just want to talk a bit about Brahma Kamal here. Somehow people have assumed and started calling the orchid cactus as Brahma Kamal in India, although both the plants have nothing in common, appearance and weather-wise. It's a species of flowering plant named after Brahma, the Hindu god of creation, and Kamal means lotus. This grows in abundance in the Himalayan regions like Valley of Flowers, Kedarnath, Tungnath, Satopant Lake, Shrikant Mahadev, etc. at an altitude of 4,500 meters, which is roughly 15,000 feet. It is also called as King of Himalayan Flowers and is a state flower of Uttarakhand. This plant is highly revered by Hindus and also used as a medicinal herb, especially in Tibetan medicine. It is endangered because people are cutting it down for their own use, for religious purpose, and also due to high demand owing to its medicinal properties. Time to take some remedial measures to protect this beauty. Okay, this is Epiphyllum occipitalum, commonly known as Queen of the Night, Dutchman's Pipe, Orchid Cactus that has showy, waxy, white flowers. Propagating the plant is super simple. I planted as a stem cutting a couple of years ago. It's a species of jungle cactus. In tropical countries, it is planted under a big tree so that it gets sufficient shade. Look at this big shoot here. The root-like structure helps the plant to keep a grip on other plants or trees to grow along vertically and also in search of light. I brought it down just to show you how it looks in close-up. Though it's a cactus variety, there are no thorns. It has long, flattened, narrow, stem-like leaves with scalloped edges. Orchid cactus does not have noticeable spines. It grows as a cluster of leaves that droop and very floppy. Soil, water and feed. I used regular potting soil mixed with very little sand and perlite for better air circulation and drainage. The idea is to drain the excess water away from the roots. This pot contains a drain hole and I water the plant once in 15 days. I use Miracle-Gro water-soluble orchid food as a feed once in 2 weeks. Light requirements. After spotting the long shoot in summer and not noticing any bloom, without realizing the serious impact it could have on the plant, I relocated it on my deck in peak summer and within few days most of the stems were totally brown like they had a sunburn. I immediately moved it indoors and started using Epsom salt meant for plants once a month. Within no time, the plant recovered, but you can still see some blemishes. Overall, the plant is thriving and has vibrant stem color and looks super healthy. This plant now receives bright, indirect light and is in a happy place, untouched. Ta-da! We spotted a bud delicately hanging to the stem a couple of weeks ago and slowly it started growing bigger and bigger, and yesterday around 9 p.m. the blooming started. What a way to end a Sunday night. The flower was at least 7 inch in dia and the whole process of blooming and withering took approximately 12 hours. Contrary to popular belief, the smell was repulsive. Overall, it's a stunning beauty and was worth the wait. I hope you enjoyed watching this video, and if you did, please like, share and subscribe. Your comments are welcome. Happy blooming. Namaste.